Dear students, welcome to the class on advances in digital image processing. We shall continue on the module 4. In today's class, we will cover the multi-resolution functions, the scaling and the wavelet. In the last class, we have studied about the series expansion, and today's class we will see about the scaling and the wavelet functions. Later on, wavelet transforms in one dimension and the fast wavelet transform. So let us say we have one function which is called as the phi of x, which is having real values, and it is a square integrable function. And we will also have a set of expansion functions which is composed of integer translations and binary scalings of this function phi of x. So this expansion function, it is called as phi of j comma k of x, where it can be written as phi of j comma k of x, it is equal to 2 power j by 2 phi of 2 to the power of j x minus k. So there are many terms over here. We will just see each of them in detail. So here, for all the values of j, this equation must be true, and the k is going to belong to the capital Z, and phi of x will belong to L square of R. Here k is going to determine the position of phi of j k of x along the x axis, and j determines the width of phi of j of k of x, that is how broad or narrow it is along the x axis. So 2 to the power of j by 2, it is going to control the amplitude of this function, and the shape of this function, it is going to change along with the j. So this phi of x, it is called as the scaling function. If I am going to choose this phi of x properly, then phi of j comma k of x, it can be made to span up till L square of R, which is the set of all measurable square integrable functions. If the j value is taken as j naught, then the resulting expansion set, it will change to phi of j naught of k of x, and this is a subset of the previous function, that is phi of j of k of x, and it is going to span a subspace of L square of R like in the previous case. This R here is a set of real numbers. The capital R is set of real numbers. Capital Z is set of integer numbers. So using the notation of the previous section, the subspace equation can now be written as V of J naught is equal to span of K, phi of J naught of K of X, it is given over here. So this V of J naught, it is a span of phi of J naught of K of X over a variable called as k. If f of x is going to belong to v of j naught, so this can be written as f of x will be equal to summation of alpha of k phi of j naught of k of x. So simply we can write this v of j will be equal to span of k phi of j comma k of x. Increasing the value of the j, it is going to increase the size of the function of vj with small variations or finer detail what has to be included in the subspace. This is because that as j increases, the function phi of j of k of x, it will be used to represent the subspace functions, and they become narrower and they will be separated by smaller changes in the variable x. The scaling function has to follow four requirements. So the first requirement is the scaling function should be orthogonal to its integer translate. So we can see from the har function, whenever the scaling function has a value of 1, its integer translate will be equal to 0. So the product of the two, that is 1 and 0, will be equal to 0. Then in the scaling function, we will have one compact support. That means whenever we are having a finite interval which is called as a support, so the value will be equal to 0. The width of the support will be equal to 1, and it will be 0 outside the half open interval, that is 0 and 1. So the requirement for the orthogonal integer translate, it becomes very hard to satisfy when the width of the support of the scaling becomes more than 1. So second requirement, the subspaces spanned by the scaling function at low scales, they are nested within those spanned at the higher scales. So we can see in the next picture that the subspaces which are containing high resolution functions must contain all low resolution functions. That is, we are having some function called as v here. So v minus infinity will be a subset of the next smaller subfunction, and then we have v of minus 1 like this. So the higher resolution functions will contain all low resolution functions. And also the basic condition, that is, if f of x will belong to v of j, then f of 2x should belong to v of j plus 1 should also be satisfied. Just because the R function is satisfying the condition of the high resolution functions within the low resolution functions, we must not assume that all the functions which are having a support width of 1 are also going to satisfy this condition number 2. So that means if I take any simple equation like phi of x is equal to 1 or 0 based on some condition, so this will be not satisfying the equation 2. This picture illustrates how the smaller functions, they are contained within the high resolution functions. So we have v0 which is smaller than v1, in turn which is smaller than v2. So the v0 is contained within v1 and v1 is contained within v2. So this is the nested function spaces which is spanned by a scaling function. So that is the requirement 2. So the requirement 3 is the function that is common to all vj functions, it is f of x will be equal to 0. If I am going to consider the coarsest possible expansion function, coarsest means the biggest one, so j is equal to minus infinity, the only representable function, it is of no information, that means v of minus infinity will be equal to 0. Condition 4 is any function can be represented with arbitrary precision. So the function f of x, we may not expand it at any arbitrary coarse resolution, but all measurable square integrable functions, they can be represented by the scaling functions where j will be tending to infinity. That is, v of infinity will be equal to l square of r, where r is the set of real numbers. So because of these four requirements, the expansion function of the subspace V of J, it can be expressed as the expansion function of V of J plus 1, which is the weighted sum. So phi of J of K of X, it is equal to summation of n alpha n phi of J plus 1 comma n of X, where the index of the summation, it is changed from k to n. Substituting for phi of j plus 1 comma n from the previous equation and changing the alpha n to h of phi of n, so this will become phi of j of k of x, it will be equal to summation of n h of phi n 2 power j plus 1 by 2 and phi of 2 to the power of j plus 1 x minus n. Because phi of x is same as phi of 0, 0 of x, and j and k, both of them are set to 0, now it becomes very simple where the phi of x will be equal to summation of n h of phi n root of 2 phi 2x minus n. So the h of phi n, what we have, this is called as the scaling function coefficient. only the h of phi, that is the scaling vector. So this equation here, it is the fundamental to any multi-resolution analysis, and this is also called as the refinement equation, the MRA equation or the dilation equation. So this expansion function of any subspace, it can be built from double resolution copies of themselves. That means the expansion functions of the next higher resolution space, they can be constructed from the low resolution space. So the choice of the reference subspace, that is the V naught, it is arbitrary. The next multi-resolution analysis is the wavelet function. So if I am having a scaling function which is meeting all the MRA requirements, we can then define a wavelet function called as psi of x, that along with its integer translates and the binary scalings, it is going to span the difference between any two adjacent scaling subspaces Vj and V of j plus 1. So the set psi of j of k of x of the wavelets, it can be expressed as 2 to the power of j by 2 psi of 2 to the power of jx minus k. K will be belonging to z. The capital Z is the set of integer numbers, and it is going to span the Wg spaces in the figure. As with the scaling functions, we can also express W of j will be equal to span of k psi of j comma k of x. If the function f of x belongs to W of j, then this f of x can be expressed as summation of k alpha k psi of j comma k of x. So here the scaling and the wavelet function subspaces, they will be related by V of j plus 1 is equal to V of j union of W of j. That means the union of the sets V of j and W of j will be belonging to V of j plus 1. So the orthogonal complement of V of j in V of j plus 1 is W of j, and all the members of the V of j, they will be orthogonal to the members of W of j. That means the phi of j k of x and psi of j of l of x, they will be equal to 0 for all values of j, k and l. And this j, k and l, they will be the integer numbers. So this picture illustrates the relationship between the scaling function and the wavelet function. So V is for the scaling function and W is for the wavelet functions. So W naught is encompassing the V naught. V1, it is composed of the union of the set W naught and the V naught. And V2 is the combination of V1 and W1. So V1 is a combination of V0 and W0. So V2 can be written as V0 and the union of W0 along with the union of W1. So this illustrates how actually the scaling functions and the wavelet functions are related. We can express all the square integrable functions, that is L square of R, as V0 union W0 union W1, it goes on. Or we can also remove this 0 and 0 and consider only from 1 onwards. Or else you can just go for removing the scaling function V1 and expressing it only in terms of the wavelet functions. We are eliminating the scaling functions and only keeping the wavelet functions. So here we are representing the function in terms of the wavelets only. So if the f of x is an element of V1 but it is not an element of V0, then the equation 7.224, that is what we are expressing in terms of V0, W0 and W1. So it is containing an approximation of f of x by using V0 scaling functions. So the wavelets from the W naught, it is going to encode the difference between this approximation and the actual function. The equations, all the equations what we just studied for the L square of R, they can all be put together and they can be generalized to yield one common equation, that is L square of R is equal to V of J naught union W of J naught union W of J naught plus 1, where this J naught is an arbitrary starting scale. Since the bigger wavelet spaces are going to be consisting of the smaller spaces, any wavelet function like its scalar function, they can be expressed as the weighted sum of shifted double resolution scaling functions. That is, the psi of x, it can be written as summation of n h of psi n root 2 psi 2x minus n. From the equation, the psi of x, we can get that h of psi of n is the wavelet function coefficient and h of psi is the wavelet vector. By using the conditions that the wavelets are going to span the orthogonal complement spaces, the integer wavelet translates will be orthogonal. So it can also be shown that h of psi of n is related to h of phi of n by the equation where h of psi of n is equal to minus 1 to the power of n, h of phi 1 minus n. So this is similar to the previous equation what we have studied, that is the relationship which is governing the impulse responses of the orthonormal subband coding and the decoding filters. Now we will study some of the wavelet transformations like the wavelet series expansion, the discrete wavelet transform and the continuous wavelet transform. So they are similar to what we have studied in the Fourier domain. In the Fourier domain also we had the discrete Fourier transform and the integral Fourier transform and the series expansion. So that will be similar to the functions what we are going to study over here with respect to the wavelets. And later on, we will develop one computationally efficient implementation of the discrete wavelet transform, and it is called as the fast wavelet transform, like the fast Fourier transform. Now we will define the wavelet series expansion of a function called as f of x, which is belonging to L square of R. This function f of x, it is relative to the wavelet function psi of x and the scaling function phi of x. F of x is also represented by scaling function expansion in the subspace V of J naught and the wavelet function expansions in subspaces W of J naught, W of J naught plus 1, etc. So the f of x can be the summation of two different variables over here. One is with respect to the wavelet function and another one is with respect to the scaling function. So in the function f of x, the j naught, it is an arbitrary starting scale, and c of j naught of k and d of j of k are now written as alpha of k. The c of j naught of k, it is called as the approximation or the scaling coefficient. The d of j of k is referred to as the detail or the wavelet coefficient. This is because in the previous equation, we were using the scaling functions to provide an approximation of the f of x at the scale j naught. For each higher scale, that is when j is greater than or equal to j naught, in the second sum, so we'll have a finer resolution function, that is sum of small wavelets, and it is added to the approximation for providing more details. If the expression of the f of x function, it is going to form an orthonormal basis or the tight frame, the expansion coefficients are calculated based on the previous equations, and we are going to get c of j naught of k and d of j of k, which is corresponding to the phi and the psi. and it will be the integral of the functions of f of x with respect to phi and f of x with respect to psi. So we know that in the previous equations, the expansion coefficients, the alpha k was defined as the inner product of the function being expanded and the expansion functions which were used. So in the equation, that is the present equations, the expansion functions are alpha of j naught of k and phi of j of k. Then the coefficients for the expansion are c of j naught and d of j. If the expansion functions are part of the bi-orthogonal basis, the phi and the psi terms in these equations must be replaced by their dual functions, phi tilde and psi tilde respectively. Like the Fourier series expansion, we can also have the discrete wavelet transformation. So the wavelet series expansion, it is going to map to a function of a continuous variable into a sequence of coefficients. If the function is discrete, then the resulting coefficients will also be discrete, and it is called the discrete wavelet transform. If f of n is equal to f of x naught plus n delta x for some x naught and delta x, and n is equal to 0 to m minus 1, the wavelet series expansion coefficients for the function f of x, it becomes the forward DWT, that is the discrete wavelet transform coefficients for the sequence f of n, w of phi and the w of psi. The phi of j naught of k of n and psi of j of k of n are the sampled versions of the basis functions phi of j naught of k and psi of j of k. So for example, if the phi of j naught of k of n, it is equal to phi of j naught of k xs plus n of delta xs for some values of xs and the delta xs, and then n is equal to from 0 to m minus 1, then we are going to employ equally spaced samples, totally m equally spaced samples over the support of the basis functions. F of n, which is the complementary inverse discrete wavelet transform, it is given by the summation of the phi and the psi. J naught will be equal to 0 and m will be the power of 2. So when we are going to add, we are going to consider the values for n is equal to 0 to m minus 1, j from 0 to j minus 1, and k will be from 0 to 2 to the power of j minus 1. For the Haar wavelets, the discretized scaling and the wavelet functions what are used here, they are corresponding to the transformation matrix of the Haar, that is m cross m. The transform is consisting of m coefficients where the minimum scale is 0 and the maximum is j minus 1. The coefficients what are defined previously, they are usually called as the approximation and the detail coefficients respectively. That is, w of phi is called as the approximation coefficient, and w of psi, it is called as the detail coefficient. The w of phi and the w of psi, they correspond to the c of j naught of k and d of j of k of the wavelet series expansion what we studied previously. The integrations in the series expansion, they have been replaced by the summations and 1 by root of m normalizing factor, which is because of the discrete Fourier transform. So it has been added to both the forward and the inverse expression. This factor, alternatively, it can be also included into the forward or the reverse alone as 1 by m instead of 1 by root m. Finally, what we are going to get will be the orthonormal basis and the tight frames. For bi-orthogonal bases, the phi and the psi terms must be replaced by their duals, that is phi tilde and psi tilde respectively. When we are going to extend the discrete wavelet transform, we are going to get the continuous wavelet transform, that is CWT, which will transform a continuous function into a highly redundant function of the two continuous variables, that is the translation and the scaling. The resulting transform, it is easy to understand and it is valuable for time frequency analysis. So we are concentrating here on the discrete images, so the continuous transform is covered here. So the continuous wavelet transform function, that is W of psi of s comma t, it is given here, which is a continuous square integrable function, and it is relative to real valued wavelet phi of x. So this equation is given as W of psi of s of t will be equal to integration of f of x, psi of x and d of x, where the psi of s comma t can be expressed as x minus t by s into 1 by root of s, where this s and t are called as the scaling and the translation parameters. So when we are given W of psi, then f of x can be computed and it is called as the inverse continuous wavelet transform. F of x will be equal to 1 by C of psi W of psi, where C of psi can be given as big psi of mu of square by mu. So where big psi of mu, it is a Fourier transform of small psi of x. So the previous equations, they are going to define a reversible transformation as long as it is admissibly criteria. That means the C of psi should be less than infinity. So in many cases, this is the psi of 0 will be equal to 0 and the psi of mu will be tending to 0 and mu is tending to infinity to make C of psi less than infinity. So in the previous equations, the similarities can be seen. All of them are with respect to the discrete counterparts. The similarities are the continuous translation parameter t takes the place of the integer translation parameter k. The continuous scale parameter s is inversely related to the binary scale parameter 2 to the power of j. This is because the s is appearing in the denominator of the psi function. So the wavelets used in the continuous transform, they will be compressed and they will be always within the width from 0 to 1 and dilated or expanded when s is greater than 1. The wavelet scale and our traditional notation of the frequency, they are inversely related. Third condition is the continuous transform, it is similar to the series expansion or the discrete transform, where the scaling is j naught equals minus infinity. This is similar to the previous equation, which is eliminating the explicit scaling function dependence, so that now the function can be represented only in terms of wavelets. Fourth condition is, like the discrete transform, the continuous transform can be seen as a set of transform coefficients, that is W of psi of s of t, that measures the similarity of f of x with a set of basis function psi of s of t. In the continuous case, both sets will be infinite because psi of s of t x is real valued and phi of s of t, it is equal to phi of star of s of t of x. Each coefficient from the equation 7.38 is a integral inner product, that is f of x and psi of s of t of x, of f of x and psi of s of t of x. The fast wavelet transform is computationally efficient implementation of the DWT. So it is a relationship between the coefficients of the DWT at adjacent scales. So these are also called as the Mallard's herringbone algorithm. The fast wavelet transform, it is similar to the two-band subband coding scheme what we have studied previously. So consider the equation for the phi of x, which is expressed in terms of h of phi and the square root of 2 of phi of 2x minus n. Scaling x by a factor of 2 to the power of j and then translating by a value k, where m will be equal to 2k plus n, it is going to simplify the equation for psi of 2 of power j of x minus k, where we will be having the equation now represented as to the power of j plus 1. So we started with 2 to the power of j, and now we can get 2 to the power of j plus 1. The scaling vector h of psi can be thought of as the weights which are used to expand the phi of 2 to the power of j of x minus k as a sum of the scale j plus 1 scaling function. A similar sequence of the operations, they are going to provide an analogous result for the psi. So that is given by this equation psi, which is given by h of psi and then 2 power j plus 1, where the scaling vector, that is h of psi of n, it is going to correspond to the wavelet vector h of psi of n. So from the previous equations and the substitutions, now we are going to get a new function, that is the wavelet defining equation d of j of k, which is f of x and 2 to the power of j of x. So when you are going to replace this psi of 2 to the power of jx minus k with the right side of the previous equation, now this can be got as the integration as well as the summation of the function f of x and the h of psi. Rearranging the terms and interchanging the sum and the integral, this equation can be written as given over here for the d of j of k. So inside the bracket what we have, that is called as c of j naught of k, with j naught equals j plus 1 and k is equal to m. So if you want to see this one, we can replace j naught and k with j plus 1 and m. Then we can get this as d of j of k with respect to h of psi and c of j plus 1. Observe that the detailed coefficients at the scale j, they are the functions of the approximation coefficients at the scale j plus 1. So by using the previous equation as a starting point for the derivation, which is involving the wavelet series expansion, we can get the similar function for the approximation coefficient, that is c of j of k, which is h of phi and c of j plus 1, where the c of j of k and d of j of k, they are the coefficients of the wavelet series expansion, and they become the w of psi and the w of phi coefficients of the DWT when the function f of x is discrete. When the function f of x is discrete, we can write the equations as w of psi and the w of phi. These equations, they are giving the relationship between the DWT, the discrete wave transform coefficients of the adjacent scales. We can compare this with the previous equation and we can see that the w of phi and the w of psi, the scale j approximation and the detailed coefficients, which are computed by convolving the w of phi j plus 1 of k, the scale j plus 1 approximation coefficients along with the order reverse scaling and the wavelet vectors h of phi and the h of psi. So here we are summarizing all the operations, and then this is going to be identical to the analysis portion of the two band subband coding and the decoding system like we have studied previously, where the H naught of n was equal to H of phi minus n and H1 of n is equal to H of psi minus n. Therefore, we can write the W of phi and the W of psi as H of phi and the H of psi, phi convolution of W of phi or the W of psi, where these convolutions will be evaluated for n is equal to 2 to the power of k and k is greater than or equal to 0. So when we evaluate the convolutions at the non-negative even indices, it is going to give the filtering and the downsampling by a factor of 2. The equations are the defining equations for the computation of the fast wavelet transform. For a sequence of length where m can be expressed as 2 to the power of j, the mathematical operations involved, they will be of the order capital O of m. So the number of multiplications and additions here are linear with respect to the length of the input sequence, because the number of multiplications and additions, they are involved in the convolutions which are performed by the fast wavelet transform analysis bank, and this is proportional to the length of the sequences which are convolved. So the fast wavelet transform, it is comparing favorably with the fast Fourier transform algorithm, which is of the order big O of m of log 2 of m operations. So to conclude on the fast wavelet transform, we can note that the filter bank, what is given in the next slide, it can be iterated to create multi-stage structures for computing for the discrete wave transforms coefficients at two or more successive scales. So for example, in the figure we can see a two-stage filter bank for generating the coefficients at the two highest scales of the transform. The highest scale coefficients are assumed to be samples of the function only. So that is W of psi of j of n, it is equal to f of n, where j is the highest value. So this picture illustrates that the filter bank can be iterated to create multi-stage structures for computing the discrete wavelet transform coefficients at two or more successive scales. This picture illustrates a two-stage or a two-scale fast wavelet transform analysis bank. This picture illustrates a two-stage fast wavelet transform's frequency splitting characteristics. We can see here it is consisting of multiple waves, V of j minus 2, W of j minus 2, W of j minus 1. And we can also see that this V of j minus 1 is consisting of V of j minus 2 and W of j minus 2. And V of j is encompassing V of j minus 2 and W of j minus 2 as well as W of j minus 1. That means the smaller functions will be part of the bigger functions. On the x-axis, we are tracing the omega value, and on the y-axis, we have H of omega. When the j is of the highest scale, then the first filter bank, what we have in the figure A, it is going to split the original function into a low pass approximation component, and this is corresponding to the scaling coefficient W of phi j minus 1 comma n, and also another high pass detail component which is corresponding to W of psi j minus 1 and n. So this can be illustrated as in the figure B, where the scaling space V of j is split into the wavelet subspace W of j minus 1 and scaling subspace V of j minus 1. The spectrum of the original function, it is split into two half band components. So the second filter bank of the figure A, it splits the spectrum and the subspace V of J minus 1, that is the lower half band, into quarter band subspaces W of J minus 2 and V of J minus 2 with corresponding DWT coefficient, that is the discrete wave transform coefficients W of phi and the W of psi respectively. The two-stage filter bank, what we have seen now, it can be extended easily to any number of scales. So if a third filter bank is operated at W of phi of J minus 2 n coefficients, then the splitting scale space V of J minus 2 into 2 8 band subspaces, that is W of J minus 3 and V of J minus 3. We can choose 2 to the power of J samples of P of X and employ P number of filter banks to generate a P scale FWT at the scales J minus 1, J minus 2 up till J minus P. That is, the first wavelet transform can be going up to the scales of J minus P from J minus 1. The higher order scales, that is J minus 1, are computed first and then we go for the last, that is J minus P. If the function f of x is sampled above the Nyquist rate, like the usual case, its samples will be good approximation of the scaling coefficients at the sampling resolution and they can be used for the starting high resolution scaling coefficient inputs. So that means no wavelet or detail coefficients will be needed at the sampling scale. The highest resolution scaling functions, they will act as unit discrete impulse functions and they will allow the f of n to be used as a scaling input to the first two band filter bank. So this is all about the multi-resolution analysis, the wavelet fast transform and the transform in the one dimension. We are going to continue on this in the next class. Thank you very much.